Hey YouTube, Optimus Smythe coming here with another video review of a Transformers movie figure. Here I have Nightwatch Leader Class Optimus Prime. Yeah, I was gonna get the ordinary Optimus Prime, but he wasn't there. So I got this one instead because he was there. Kind of didn't want to, but they're the same thing really, just different paint jobs. That's pretty much the only difference. Yeah, and it's really cool too. I'm thinking about getting Premium Prime, but I don't know. Instead, I think I might wait for that awesome Leader Class Double Blade Optimus from Revenge of the Fallen. This is a really awesome figure. I was impressed with the way they made the Leader Prime. Even though he wasn't too movie accurate, he is still awesome. And yeah, I don't have the Leader Optimus Prime that's the correct paint job. I do have the Voyager one, which some of you probably didn't know because I haven't done a stop motion of him yet, but oh well. This one's cool. I think it's kind of symbolical to me since I'm like probably the only Transformers fan that doesn't have the ordinary Optimus Prime. So I kind of think of this as kind of like my Optimus Smythe symbol, sort of. It became my icon for a while then, but then I came up with my own Autobot customized logo that I drew in paint. But yeah, this guy is really cool. He's, the one awesome thing about him is his wheels are rubber. It's like a Hess truck, and it is so awesome. It's, well, it's like a dark metallic gray with the smokestacks and the gas pipes and these things and the grill. The flames are spray painted a beautiful silver, which is awesome. And his lights are like more like a purple. Same with the windshield and the windows also. They're like translucent purple. And there's also black somewhere, like, right there. And this is the gun right here, in case you didn't notice. If you want to, you can take that out. In fact, let's just kind of start the transformation by taking that out and setting it aside. But let me show you something else. This is the lights and sounds gimmick. That little button right there, if you press it, lights and sounds, it makes the honking noise. Yeah, really cool. Okay. The rating for this guy is a definite 10 out of 10. He deserves a 10 out of 10. He is awesome. Yeah, he is really cool. And this is an awesome truck. It is huge. Yeah, and also the smokestacks are rubber, and they're flat at the top. They're not slanted. I don't know why, but oh well. Now, let's start the transformation before I go too long. What I do first, I guess, is just pull the back wheels up like that. Next, separate both of these sides of the front of the nose of the truck, like that. Put the whole front down like that. And next, pull these things down, like that. And fold them to the side. Make sure they're folded all the way to the side, that they're not like that, that they're pushed out all the way like that. I had trouble the first time transforming them because of that. Detach this and push these things up. That's be opened already. Just push them up so that then you can take both of these things and flip them forward snug right next to the whole body of the truck, which is going to be his chest. And then push this thing up. This can be hard to do because this whole thing will bend with it. Make sure it doesn't get in the way. It goes right by his leg. It just scratches it. That's why those things have to be in all the way or it won't work. Flip them in like that. Can you see that? What I do next is pull the arms out. Straighten them out as best you can. Take these shoulder panel things and put them down and turn them around like that and put these things up. For the hands, open this thing up. Sometimes those things like to fall out on their own. Pull the hand up, close it back up. Take the thumb, and I'd put it on top like that to make it look more realistic. Next, now for the legs. Pull these things up like that and bend them in so they're like the kneecap, shin guards, something like that. Pull the legs apart. Oh, one more thing I forgot to do. Take the whole crotch area and push it forward, bending the legs at the same time until that little square hole right there will click in place with that. Now for the feet, this is a really cool automorph gimmick. Do this. Pull it down, slide it forward, and the toes will come out, and then bend that thing back. Same with the other one. Detach that, put it down, bend that silver part up like this, and put them flush against the back of his legs, I guess. Now, for the final touch, the awesomest part, watch this. Automorph gimmick, lights and sounds, really awesome transformation. His head pops up like that, I love it. And now for his gun, for weapon storage, just put it on that little rectangular niche right there. Like that, and it'll just hang there. To make that come forward, where is it? Oh, I can't find, oh. Right here on the inside of his arm. Can you see? I'm pointing at it right there. Pull that forward and watch what happens. His gun will come forward, but not only that, watch what else happens. Look down at the bottom, right here. That little barrel will come out on its own. Let's see what happens without the gun. Watch. Comes out on its own. Really cool feature. Crap, I just lost the missile. Again. I will look for that later. The missile is like a purplish tint, like his windshield. Okay, I just tried finding the missile and I couldn't. Here he is in all his glory. It's a really awesome leader class figure. It's pretty bulky. It's got a lot of kibble on the back here and on the back of the legs. Not very movie accurate, but it is still awesome. Okay, it is still really awesome. The head is really cool. It can only rotate like that. It cannot go all the way around because of the wires in it for the light piping in his head, but who cares? It's still awesome. And yeah, good posability too. He's a lot more posable than Movie Megatron, mainly because of the fact that his feet are ball and socketed. Yeah. And you can only bend his legs back if you bend this thing back. And then pull the leg back. It doesn't go back. Well, maybe it does sort of go back far, but not maybe that far, but it's still awesome. Yeah. He's really cool. He's double jointed at his elbows right there and here. Yeah, and the fingers, all of them can come out at the same time. Or you can have some come out. Let's put the two middle ones in. Rock on. Or you can just have him pointing. No, I am not going to show him doing the finger. I'm not an idiot. Okay? I'm not an idiot. I'm not a pervert. I'm not going to have him give the finger, okay? Please don't ask me to do that. Okay, and you can still see the pipe, the smokestacks are up here. Not on his shoulders like in G1, they're still up here, but it's okay. And then these things, if you want to, you can put those down. I keep them up, though, for more realism. They're really cool. Yeah. This figure is really awesome. I highly recommend this for movie fans, okay? For anyone, okay? Optimus is probably one of the most iconic characters in the movie because he looks just like G1 Optimus. He looks a lot more realistic, but he's got the same colors and everything. And he does have toes instead now, and a lot more silver parts. But still, he looks just like G1 Optimus. This one apparently doesn't, though, because it's Nightwatch Prime. But yeah, the only difference with these guys is this one has a different paint job. He's that navy blue with a couple of sky blue colors, like, on his legs, and somewhere else on his shoulders right there, and inside here. And yeah, there's some gold parts right there, and right next to the blue right there. So we can see new colors now. There's also some cyan colors on his head somewhere. Yeah, his face is really awesome looking. Very realistic.
Yeah.
And my final rating for this guy, well, you guessed it right, 10 out of 10. He is awesome, okay? I don't care the fact that he's all boxy and stuff. He's a leader, you know, what did you expect? He's awesome. Okay, that's all I have to say. So, Optimus Smythe signing off.